Hello?
Good evening. Can I please speak to the assistant manager of this establishment?
Pardon me?
I'm calling from the Vermilion Police Station. My name is Officer Collins. I have Nicole Jean on the other line, who, if I have it correct, is the manager of this establishment.
Yes, Nicole's manager here. How can I help you, officer? Is there a problem?
I need to speak with the assistant manager.
You're speaking to one of them, sir.
Good. Like I said, I have your manager, Nicole, on the other line. We suspect that one of the employees of this establishment has stolen personal belongings from a customer's handbag.
Oh, boy.
Now, I'm asking for your utmost cooperation and total discretion in this matter, please. What's your name?
My name's Diane, sir. I mean, I'll help you however I can. But wait, you're telling me that one of our employees has stolen something from a handbag. Do you know who it is? What should I do? What am I supposed to maybe...
Calm down, miss. Well, first of all, what we have here is an accusation against a person of this establishment. The suspect. No culprits. The law doesn't work like that. Now, so someone has reported a theft. So now what we need to do is find evidence that proves that that person who we suspect has, in fact, committed the crime. Do you understand?
Yes, sir, I do.
Okay, so the only thing I need of you is for you to detain the suspect until a squad car arrives on location. The person who's made the report described the suspect as a young white female, no more than 20 years old. Let's see, dark hair, short, approximately 90 pounds, dressed in a green uniform. Do any of your employees fit this description?
Yes, I think so.
Good. Do you have any available rooms at your disposal where you might be able to temporarily detain this person?
Excuse me?
I'm just asking if you have at your disposal some sort of room that could be used to detain this person until our officers arrive. It should be a somewhat isolated room that's not visible to the clientele. This matter needs to be carried out with the utmost discretion in order to not interfere with the run of the restaurant or with the investigation. The customers don't need to know what's going on here. You understand that way we can also avoid the suspect the embarrassment of being arrested in public. Let's see, do you think the room where you're in now could work?
Well, it is the office. I mean, it's not very secure, but yeah, customers can see back here. But I really don't think it's a secure place. I mean, she could possibly escape.
Well, let's see now, Diane. We're not dealing with terrorists. If you're worried that she will escape, like, say, through the window, you'll need to stay and guard her. Do you consider the suspect to be a violent person?
No. Quite the opposite, actually.
Oh. So there's nothing to worry about then, right?
I'm sorry, officer. I'm just a little nervous.
That's okay. Everything will be fine. I understand that in these restaurant chains, you're trained to cooperate with law enforcement. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm, yes. Well, us managers are trained for this, yes. Not everybody, but the managers are, yes.
Okay. So you should be familiar with this type of situation. So there's nothing to worry about. I'm sure you'll do just fine. So, bring the suspect to the room. You haven't told me her name yet, by the way.
Oh, yes. Laura. Her name's Laura Combast.
Laura. Good. Well, bring Laura in.
Here she is. This is the girl you described. Laura, shut the door, please.
What's going on?
Nothing. Don't worry.
Tell her what's happening. There's no problem. Go ahead and fill her in.
Laura, look. Well, I've got the police on the phone. It seems that a customer is accusing you of taking something from her purse. They're sure it's you. The customer described you to the police, and I don't know anything else.
But I don't know anything about it.
The victim assures us that her wallet and other valuables went missing from her handbag and is positive that this happened while she was in your establishment. Once she realized, she was already far from the location. But she clearly remembers having seen Laura, looking suspicious, and so now it's our turn to intervene.
They say you stole someone's wallet.
What? But Diane, I didn't do anything.
Diane, tell her that she's only a suspect. She's not necessarily guilty.
Okay, you're not guilty. You're just a suspect.
I haven't done anything wrong. Please believe me, Diane. I could never steal. I could never do anything like that. I don't have it in me.
Girl, I don't know. They said it was someone who looked like you, wearing our green uniform. They described you.
That's it. Tell her it's nothing too serious. It'll be serious if she refuses to cooperate. Then it'll be much worse.
It's nothing serious, Laura. If you don't cooperate, it'll be worse. If you resist, it'll only make matters worse, and you know going against authority won't do you any good.
Police are here to protect your security. Now, if she didn't do anything wrong, well, she's got nothing to worry about.
If you didn't do anything wrong, you have nothing to worry about, okay?
Okay, but I didn't do anything.
All right, good. Since she's being cooperative, we'll try something. Maybe it won't be necessary to send a squad car after all.
He says if you behave, they won't send a squad car.
Diane, that's not exactly what I said.
Oh.
What I was saying is that Laura can choose between two options. Refuse to cooperate and force us to bring her in, or agree to submit to a search there, in that room.
Oh, I got it.
Okay, go ahead and explain it to her.
Laura, the officer said that you can choose between a search here or at the station. What I mean is that if you cooperate, you won't have to be put into a police car and taken to the station and then searched there and so on.
A search?
I'm sorry, officer. Is this going to take long? I have a lot of work to do. Fridays here are just crazy.
It's going to take a while, yes. And please, don't call me officer. Call me Larry. Okay, Diane?
Okay, but...
All right. If you don't have time, we should find somebody to replace you. Well, but before that, we have to take some precautionary measures. Ask Laura to give you her cell phone and her car keys. Well, that way she won't be able to go very far if she were to decide to leave while you're gone. Understand? And go get someone to assist you. Meanwhile, I'll keep talking to your boss, Nicole. She's still waiting on the other line.
Okay, my coworker, the other assistant manager, Ann, is here. Can I go now?
To be honest, I'd prefer it if you stayed, Diane. Or would it be possible for her to cover for you for a bit? You've done really well so far. And in fact, you can be sure that I'm going to personally tell your superiors how well you did. I've already mentioned something to Nicole.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, you're welcome, Diane. It's my duty. All right, good. Has Laura decided if she prefers to be searched there or at the station?
Yeah, before a moment ago she said it. We convinced her between the two of us.
Hey, Dan,
did you just go? And you go. Do you mind covering me for a while?
Wait a second. Can Ann stay for a moment? Let's see. For the search, Laura should take off all of her clothing, and Ann, or, if you prefer you can do it yourself, should take the clothing to one of your cars. Meanwhile, the other person will stay with Laura.
I don't get it.
You should leave the clothing outside the restaurant, in your car. Police officer will come by to pick up the clothing. I'll let you know when they've arrived. That way they won't have to go into the restaurant. We need to maintain the utmost discretion, remember?
But why does she have to take off her clothes?
Don't tell me how to do my job, miss. It's the standard procedure.
What is she saying?
You gotta take your clothes off for the search.
All of her clothes, even her underwear. If she's embarrassed, she can have something to cover herself with, some sort of towel or something.
Anne, go get an apron from the back.
Sir, are you still there?
Yes, Diane.
Okay, well, Anne just went to put the clothes in her car.
Oh, good, good.
But, sorry, officer, I've really got to go. I've called over a guy from the kitchen to take over. His name's Jake. I'll put him on. I've got things to do, and I'm really sorry. Here's Jake.
Hello? What's going on, Diane? Why's Laura naked?
Hello, Jake. I'm Officer Collins. Laura is naked because we suspect she's stolen something, and we're going to search her with your help.
What? Hold on a minute. Diane, don't go.
Jake, the police need you to collaborate.
No.
Just describe to me what you see. I'll do the thinking. It's very easy.
What I see? I see my coworker naked and covering herself with an apron. That's what I see. Is this really necessary?
Remove the apron, Jake.
What? Officer, I'm not gonna do
it. Remove the apron, Jake. She could be hiding something. Jake? Jake?
Officer Collins?
Hello, Diane. What happened with Jake? He left me hanging. I didn't like that one bit.
Diane, can we get this over with, please?
I don't know.
Jake seems pretty angry. He didn't answer any of my questions and just said he didn't want to have anything to do with this.
Well, unfortunately, this is going to have to get serious. What we have here is no laughing matter, and it can't wait. I just spoke with Nicole, and I've explained to her what happened with Jake. And from what she said, I really doubt Jake will be working there next week. Nicole doesn't want employees who refuse to cooperate with law enforcement, and much less get in the way.
Oh, I see, officer. But why don't you send a squad car so we can get this over with?
Diane, we're already on that. It's a bit like with you and hamburgers. It's Friday. It's peak time. And please, stop calling me officer or sir. Call me Larry. I'm calling you Diane, aren't I?
Okay, Larry.
Well, plus, and I shouldn't be telling you this, but I'm going to. The police officers who were going to the restaurant have been redirected to the suspect's home to search the premises. We have reason to believe that Laura's been dealing drugs.
Oh, my God.
Okay, Diane, either way, you are all as busy as we are. Everyone has work to do, and I can imagine that with Laura away from her job, things must be getting quite hectic. But we agree that something must be done. And what we certainly don't want is to leave the suspect alone in the room as Jake did. I've got an idea. Are you married?
Pardon me?
I'm asking if you're married. I'm not trying to date you or anything.
No. Well, I'm engaged, but...
Oh, could your fiancé possibly come down there with you just to sit and keep an eye on the suspect?
Well, I think he's home now. In fact, it's not very far from here.
Okay, call him up.
Okay, just a minute. I'm dialing him on my cell phone. 1 minute. But he's not allowed to come back here if he doesn't work here.
Well, that's not a problem. I'm speaking with Nicole right now, and considering the gravity of the situation, I'm sure it won't be a problem. And tell Laura to stop crying.
Larry, are you still there? Brian's here.
Brian's your fiancé's name?
Yes.
Okay, put him on.
Hello?
Hello, Brian.
Hello.
I'm Police Detective Collins. Has Diane explained to you the situation we have here?
Yes, she's put me up to speed, sir. She's also introduced me to the girl.
Oh, good. Tell your fiancé she can go ahead and go.
Diane,
One minute, I forgot something. Tell her also that I confirmed with her boss, Nicole, that you have complete authorization to be there. She's very happy with how Diane dealt with the situation.
Baby, the officer says there's no problem. You can go. Oh, and then Nicole gave me permission to be here. Oh, and that she's happy with how you've dealt with the whole situation.
Oh, really? Okay, so I can go.
Yes, go.
Okay, I'll see you later, huh?
Okay. Are you sure Diane gave you all the details? I'll summarize just in case. The girl in front of you, her name is Laura. She works there, and we suspect that she stole from a customer in the restaurant. Now, I won't go into details about what she stole or how. You don't need to know that. But we have good reason to believe it was her. We could even say that we're certain that she did it. And we also have reason to believe that she's been dealing drugs through the restaurant. Officers are searching her house right now. That's it. That's all you need to know. Now I need your help.
Yes?
It's very simple. As you can see, the girl has no clothes on. This is because we're going to search her. But for a number of reasons, we still haven't been able to carry out the search.
I think I got it. Well, what do I have to do?
Okay, listen carefully. All I ask is that you be my eyes and my hands. I want to be in that room. I want to be there through you.
Oh, I'll do what I can, officer.
Limit yourself to just following my instructions. Piece of cake, I promise. Now, this also requires your utmost discretion. Don't forget that you're collaborating with the law. And in a way, by following my instructions, you're acting temporarily as a representative of the law. And because of this, a responsible attitude is necessary. But again, I insist, all you'll have to do is follow my instructions. There's nothing complicated, Brian. Agreed?
Yes.
Okay, let's get started. Tell me what you see.
I see the girl.
Describe her to me.
She's a brunette, 20 years old at the most.
I'm 18.
18? She's been crying. Her eyes are all red. To be honest to me, She doesn't look like a thief at all.
I'm not asking for your opinion, Brian. I want description, nothing else. Is the suspect naked?
Yes. Well, she's covering herself with an apron.
Remove the apron and describe what you see. Okay. Tell her to stand up and bend over. She could be hiding something between her butt cheeks.
But I'm just not...
Do as I'm telling you, please.
Well, I... Laura, get up. Okay, now, bend this way.
But Brian, what does this have to...
No, Laura should be addressing you as sir, Brian. She should call you sir.
The officer says you have to call me sir, Laura.
Not the officer says. You are the authority, Brian. And try not to call her by her name from now on. Address her as Miss.
Okay, I get it.
Repeat after me. Don't call me by my name, Miss. Call me sir.
Don't call me by my name, Miss. Call me sir.
Now, bend over and show me your backside. Repeat it, Brian.
For real, I don't see anything.
Make her stand on a chair. Give the phone to Laura.
What?
The phone. Give her the phone. I want to talk to her. All this telling you what to say is getting on my nerves.
The officer wants to talk to you, Miss.
Miss. Very good.
Yeah?
Hello, Laura. Okay. You know we're looking for something. Do you know where it is?
I didn't do anything, sir. Please believe me.
I believe you. I do. But I also believe the person who's reported you. You understand? Please be cooperative.
But I didn't do anything bad, for real.
You see, miss, if you cooperate with us, I will do all that is in my power for you not to get fired. And believe me, there's no doubt that you're at risk of losing your job at this moment. You want to keep your job, don't you?
Yes, of course. But this doesn't...
Trust me, Laura. Oh, please. And I'll trust you. Now, you understand that if you keep on questioning the authorities, you're only giving me more reason to be suspicious of you.
But why do
Miss,
I...
Miss, the more you talk back to me, the guiltier you seem. You choose. Cooperate or face the consequences. Now give the phone back to Brian.
Okay. What do we do now?
Okay. We'll keep searching her. Tell her to...
Wait. Diane just came back. Do you prefer to talk to her?
Everything okay, Brian?
No. Is the girl exposed? Give her back the apron.
Oh, no, okay. Yes, honey, everything's fine.
You don't want Diane to think we're having fun with the girl, do you? I mean, the girl's been trying to come off as helpless to get Diane on her side, whimpering the whole time. Keep alert, Brian. This girl is not what she seems. Now, she'll take advantage of the smallest opportunity to manipulate you or your fiancé with her helpless animal act. You get me? Let's see. When I asked for your discretion, I meant this too, Brian. Now, it sounds bad saying it like this, but not even Diane should find out what's going on in this room when she's not there.
Why?
Imagine for a minute that you're Diane, and you come into the room, and the first thing you see is Laura naked, all teary-eyed, staring at you with a get-me-out-of-here look. Can you imagine? Well, this is what Laura wants to happen. Now, believe me, I've dealt with lots of people like her. They're experts at deception, able to manipulate someone's feelings without them knowing.
I got it. And what should we do about it?
The only way to deal with these people is to make them submit. And we have to disarm them, show them who's boss. Is Diane still there?
Yes.
Well, let's wait for her to leave. Meanwhile, I'll explain to you what we're going to do. It may be possible that Laura's hidden something in some orifice of her body. You understand me?
Hello? Diane just left.
Okay. Get that apron off.
Give me that.
I'll tell her to sit somewhere elevated, maybe a table, and show you her vagina. Tell her to open her legs and show you. It's highly probable that in this position, you'll be able to see if she's introduced an object in there.
Wait a second. Here, cover yourself. And don't tell Diane.
What's going on?
Nothing. Hey, Diane. Sir? Okay. Diane's gone. Give me the apron, miss. Okay.
Get her on her feet.
Stand up, miss. I said stand up.
Arms up.
Arms up.
I tell her to jump.
What?
I mean to jiggle around, to shake loose anything she's hiding.
But I just...
Do as I say, damn it.
Jump.
What?
Dance. Do jumping jacks or something. Move your body.
But I don't get what this is supposed to be.
Do what I say. Now. Come on. One, two.
This is ridiculous.
Shut up and do as I say. Like this. Open your legs more as you dance. Look. Like this. And jump more. I don't know. Jiggle. Just shake loose whatever you got in there.
Anything? Did anything fall out?
No. Nothing.
Tell her to turn around. Look at her ass while she jumps. Tell her to dance with her legs spread open.
This is ridiculous. I refuse to keep doing this shit, Brian. I didn't do anything wrong. How long is she gonna last?
Don't speak to me that way, miss.
Stop the mess thing. Where are the cop cars? I want to get
Brian,
out of here.
Brian, don't let her get a hold of the reins. Repeat after me. Miss?
Miss?
With authority. Don't make me have to force you, miss.
Don't make me have to force you, miss.
Look, Brian, this doesn't make any sense. We barely know each other, but you know that I would never...
Don't call me Brian. Call me sir.
Don't call me Brian. Call me sir.
This is completely insane.
Sit down now.
Sit down now.
Hold her down. Show that punk who's boss. Restrain her, Brian.
Stay still, damn it. Come on. Come on. You see? You got nothing on me. I have her restrained, officer.
Lay her across your lap. Smack her ass.
What?
Don't go soft on me now, Brian. That's what she wants. For you to go soft. Don't you see? Smack her. Show her who's in charge. Smack her. Show her what happens when you defy authority.
Brian, this doesn't make any sense.
Shut up! I'm gonna smack you until you show me the respect I deserve.
But Brian, what the hell?
You asked for it!
What? Ouch!
Shut it! Now you're gonna see. I'm gonna spank you like a little kid. That'll teach you... You think you can laugh at me, but you're not...
This is crazy! It's gonna be...
I won't stop until you shut your mouth, you stupid little girl!
That's it. Don't stop. Don't hold back, Brian. Show her what's coming to her if she doesn't obey.
This is what you get for not listening. That'll teach you. And don't scream.
Why are you... Ow!
I told you not to scream. If you scream, it'll be worse, you little bitch.
Tell her while you're hitting her. I'm spanking you because you've been bad.
I'm spanking you because you've been bad. Defying authority. Not calling me sir.
Keep hitting her until you're tired. Tell her, I'm gonna hit you until I'm tired. Till your ass is all red.
I'm gonna hit you till your ass is all red. Till my arm gets tired. Don't move, you bitch!
Please, this doesn't have to be... Ow!
And this pain you're gonna feel is a reminder of what will come to you if you keep deciding to disobey. You understand? Say yes, sir.
This is what you'll get if you insist on defying us. You understand, you stubborn punk? Say yes, sir.
Yes, sir, I understand.
Good. Now get comfortable, because like I said, I ain't going to stop until I get tired. And I never lie.
Repeat after me, Brian. Miss, if you want to keep your job and avoid further punishment, you understand that you have no other option but to comply. Listen carefully. Now sit her on your lap and kiss her. Tell her so you can smell anything suspicious on her breath. We're having a really hard time getting the girl to confess. We've humiliated her and psychologically broken her down. And we've got her between a rock and a hard place. She still won't talk. Not even kissing her.
I haven't detected anything strange on her breath, sir.
Yeah, I can imagine. Look, we're going to have to play one last card. Tell her to kneel in front of you and unbuckle your pants.
But I don't...
Do as I say, Brian.
It won't work. It's not...
Don't let the suspect see you hesitate. Do what I told you. Don't think about it.
Get on your knees, miss, and undo my belt buckle.
That's it. Between a rock and a hard place.
Did you hear what I said? On your knees. Now.
No, please. This is crazy. I didn't...
On your knees, bitch. Now. Or do you want me to hit you some more?
Please, stop. I just... me to do it?
I'm going to count to three.
All right. Look, I'll undo it myself. See how easy that is? Look at it. Okay, you still have time to tell us what we want to hear. You choose. Enough with the lies. You choose.
But...
You've been laughing at us this whole time. Confess. Come on. Confess or face this. Where is what you stole?
And where are the drugs you've been trafficking?
And where are the drugs you've been trafficking?
What?
No. What is not the answer I'm looking for?
We found drugs in your house.
We found drugs in your house.
What? That's impossible. I don't hear...
I don't nothing. Confess now. You're trapped. Confess or suck on this. Answer the question now.
I haven't done anything.
Okay. Wrong answer. That's it. Suck it. I said... Suck it! Open your mouth or I swear I'll...
Officer, did you call for me?
Yes, I told your fiancé to call you. I need to get someone else. Brian's done all he could do, but it turns out this girl's really giving us a hard time. Brian can go.
Oh, but come on. We've been at this since 5 o'clock. When are the police coming?
We're still extremely busy, ma'am. The squad car that was on its way there has already been diverted 2 times to deal with more urgent matters. Plus, let me remind you that we're still searching the girl's home. Please, find another man to deal with the girl until we arrive.
Look, I got Phil. He's in charge of maintenance here.
Oh, fantastic. Thanks a lot, Diane.
Hello?
Hey, Dave. You got a minute?
Oh, hey, Brian. What's up, buddy?
Dave, man. I've done something really bad.
Okay, Phil. Do you understand what I need you to do?
Yeah, but I'm not doing any of that. I'm sorry. I refuse. Goodbye, sir.
Hey, Diane. Something isn't right about this.
What's wrong?
This ain't right. He wants me to take off the poor girl's apron to get her naked.
Is Diane still there?
Yeah, he wants me to describe what I see.
What? Give me that phone. Larry, what does this mean?
Oh, my God, Phil. Oh, my God. Hurry. Go get Ann. Oh, shit. No, wait here with me.
Yes?
Nicole, explain to me what's going on.
What?
Nicole, Diane, I've been talking to Officer Collins.
What the hell are you talking about? Calm down a little.
Officer Collins.
Who the hell is Officer Collins?
What?
What are you talking about? Who's Officer Collins?
The police officer! The one that's been talking
Diane,
to
me! Diane, I've been sleeping the whole afternoon. I haven't been talking to anybody. Can you please tell me what's going on?
Oh, my God.
What's wrong, Diane?
Oh, my God. Phil, get this poor child out of here. Bring her clothes into her ass car. Get the keys from it.